Yo, what is going on, you guys? Bastion YJ here, and today I want to go ahead and talk to you guys real quick about this exciting sleeper deck. Just got brand new support, very low key, very under the table. Post Age of Overlord, we actually have Sharks coming in at one of the scariest low tier decks possible. And it is made even more possible by, again, some scary little support it just got in Age of Overlord as well. Like I said, guys, we just got some brand new support. We got Xyz armored cards that I personally thought was absolutely garbage. I mean, don't get me wrong, again, big fan of Zexal, yada yada yada, all that type of things. I did not really think that this was going to be that viable until I am starting to see a lot more sharp combos and sharp test hands and shark deck profiles start pop up online everywhere, topping here and there. Nothing crazy yet, but I do believe that this is actually pretty decent sleeper deck for the format, guys. I'm gonna tell you guys why in this video, but before we get started with that, guys, make sure you guys check the link in the description for the merch. Make sure you guys like the video and let's get right into it, because today we're gonna be checking out some combos and we're gonna be doing a quick deck profile, quick deck list rundown for you guys, just to show you guys exactly just how powerful this deck can really be. So guys, I want to go ahead and just run over with you guys why this deck is so scary in my opinion. So right off the bat, guys, you guys can already see we have a lot of variety here, a lot of one-offs, not necessarily a bad thing, although it can be seen as an inconsistent type thing. No, that's not the case this at all. These are all either one card starters or fantastic extenders. The deck, all the monsters in this deck are all extenders, which is phenomenal for your strategy, of course. And aside from that, guys, at the very worst case scenario, what this deck is putting up is two Totally Awesome, two Omni Gates putting up against your opponent. Obviously, it's going to be Omni Gate as your fourth summon, so you are going to be playing around Nibiru each and every single time. Even if you get impermed, you can send stuff to the grave and revive it back. Special summon from your hand. I mean, there's so many additional ways this deck can essentially just keep going off. It feels very, very much like a Salamangreat deck. If Salamangreat had multiple ways to interrupt you besides the two traps that the deck has, Rage and Roar, this feels like a much more revved up version, a much more ramped up version, a much more consistent version. Well, consistent, okay, I still have to get down to Salamangreat. I'm not gonna go that far, but it's still extremely powerful in what it can actually do. You may see a lot of level 5 monsters. These level 5 monsters can be treated as level 3, 4, 5 monsters, depending on if you're going to be Xyz summoning. Sometimes for a number monster, then it lets you go into amazing cards like number 4 Stealth Kragan, which makes all facet monsters in the field become water types, which then extends really well with a card like Gozen Match, which I have seen main decked in some instances, which is really ridiculous. And this card can go clean off because you're making all your opponent's monsters water. They summon anything, you flip this, and that way they can't summon anything that is not a water monster, which is ridiculous to think about, guys. An immediate blowout shutout card, all those types of things. So honestly, I'm very, very excited to see what potentially may become of this deck. I'm definitely going to be weary in the lower tier for rounds 1, 2, and 3 because this deck can potentially sneak up on you. Actually, it wasn't that long ago. I believe it was August. We actually had Sharks top 32 regional. So with that being said, guys, I think the hype is very, very much real. I think this deck is super, super crazy. Potentially, it can search Gamma Seal, which searches it can search a Kaiju of all things. It doesn't matter if any Kaiju is good. The fact you can search the best Kaiju being Gamma Seal is even that much better, guys. And that's not the only thing. Of course, you can do just so much tanger. So I just feel like I keep saying the same things. But let's go ahead and talk about the quick deck profile real quick. So this is my basic shark list. I haven't tested this, as in like going to locals, whatever. I don't have the cards, but I've been noodling around with it online and everything like that, and it is really, really interesting to see how the deck overall combos off. Let's go ahead and just put the most updated ban list just in case I messed up somewhere. But I'm overall playing 3 copies of Abyss Shark. Abyss Shark is absolutely ridiculous. If all monsters you control are water, you can special summon this card from your hand, and if you do, you can add one level 3, 4, or 5 fish monster from your deck to your hand, except Abyss Shark. Then you can only special summon water monster for the rest of the turn, which is really perfectly fine because all of them should be water monsters in your extra deck, except for like Zeus, Typhon, and then in the events you want to normal summon Ash, but I don't think it's really necessary. So that's something you have to keep in mind when playing this deck, is that a few of these cards are going to lock you into like water types or fish only or whatever it might be, and that can alter the lines of play that you are going to be choosing in your strategy. So you guys are going to be aware of that. You guys are going to have to keep yourself accountable for that. I'll probably recommend you should always have a pen and paper regardless for any Yu-Gi-Oh event. If you guys want to go ahead and keep it down and mark down what you are locked under, that way you don't misplay, because if you go pretty far within it, it could potentially lead to some potential rulings going against you in your favor. So three Abyss Shark, crazy card, free special summon and the search of anything you want. Three Buzzsaw Shark, probably the best normal summon in the entire deck. You can target a water monster you control. It doesn't say not including itself, so you can even target itself. Special summon from your deck in defense position any fish monster with the same level as that monster. You special summon basically any level 4 for free, and you get to go ahead and go clean off from there. So primarily what I like to do is I go ahead and get this guy, Buzzsaw Shark, and I summon out the Silent Angler, because what I like with Silent Angler is that when I get cards like White Mirror onto my hand, into my hand, I can actually target the Silent Angler in my graveyard, special summon it, and then add another Silent Angler from my deck to my hand, which is really, really good, of course. But Silent Angler does have the additional restriction to where you cannot special summon monster from the hand for the rest of this turn after you special summon this guy. That's why I only am playing two of this guy, guys. Two of the Lifeless Leaffish. I think two is just fine. If you want to play three, I'm not going to fight you on it. If you want to play one, I'm not going to fight you on it. But I just think it's a really, really good normal summon as well. Just have that additional option for you. Two copies of XYZ Remora, a more restrictive special summon, because you have to detach two materials from monsters you control on a special summon it, which can hurt. But in the event you have two Bahamut Sharks that you, or a Bahamut Shark, whatever it might be, that you already summoned, that you're totally awesome for, then that's a dead material, because realistically it's not going to last that long until your next turn. So you can go ahead and detach that along with another one to go ahead and get summon this guy out. You can also use the materials of your Stealth Kraken. It's not that necessarily it's not necessarily to have, so it is something you can definitely do. Crystal Shark is just a one of. Basically, it's just a free extender, but it does restrict you to summoning out the number monsters with it. One Lantern Shark, of course, the card normal special summon. You can activate the effect to special summon a level 3, 4, or 5 water monster from your hand in defense position. It's not nearly as good, obviously, as Buzzsaw Shark, because it does special summon from your hand instead of your deck, which is not the best, but, you know, it's still gives you that additional wave of an extender for you. One Right Hand Shark, one copy of Minai Ruka. When a water monster's effect is activated, you can special summon this card from your hand. Really crazy effect, which you're going to be activating a lot of water monster's effects, so it's a free special summon essentially. You can manage to face up fish, sea serpent, aqua monster you control, then target one face up crown of field, negate its effects until the end of your opponent's turn, which is of course crazy to consider. Definitely one that I want to go ahead and make sure is in my main deck guaranteed. A Silent Sea Nettle, of course, you control a water monster, special summon this card from your hand, a restriction to water monsters, and the Gamma Seal, because you can search it potentially with the Foolish Burial and the Ice Barrier card. It's funny that Ice Barrier is not an Ice Barrier card, which I think is weird, unless you can actually use an in Ice Barrier, but I have not tried it. Three copies of Ash Blossom, one Instant Fusion, two White Mirror. I can consider playing three, but three is too much, too bricky. Two triple tactics talents, of course, three Foolish Burial goods. There's really not going to be a third card you're going to be activating of the third Foolish Burial goods, but realistically, by the time you activate the second one, you should really have already won the game at that point. So that's why I just played the three, because it is it's like having three copies of Reinforcement of the Army, because you activate this, you send your Ice Barrier. Ice Barrier has a wild effect when it's sent to the graveyard. You can manage card from the graveyard, then send one level 5 or higher monster from your deck, water monster from your deck to the graveyard, then add one water monster from your graveyard to your hand. And it does not say another one, so you just send the one you want, and you add that right back to your hand, then you're good to go from there, which is just crazy. Which is how you're able to go ahead and search out Gamma Seal. Three copies of Pop Prosperity, Called by the Grave, three Forbidden Droplets, because his deck can definitely play it. You're going to have a lot of leftover resource potentially on your field that you're just potentially not going to need. So you can go ahead and use those, or just additional cards in your hand, just to go ahead and negate whatever your opponent has and take it from there. Two Impromptu Ice Barrier, and one copy of the brand new Full Armor Xyz card. Crazy card that lets you Xyz summon on your opponent's turn. Also lets you attach one of your Xyz monsters in your graveyard, which is probably going to be Bahamut Shark, to one of your Xyz monsters, which will be your Full Armor Dark Lancer, Dark Knight Lancer, which has a crazy effect. So when it is equipped, when something is equipped to it, it gains the effect to non-target attach one of your opponent's monsters to it as a material, which immediately counters decks like potentially Manadium. So the second that they normal summon Meek, you activate this effect, you equip a card to it, and then that attaches Meek to it as a material, which means it's not getting destroyed, but it is leaving the field, and now they don't have a target on the field to go ahead and target with the Rhyum Heart. And I think that's pretty spicy. Also with decks like Chimera Branded, they activate their Birthomet in order to go ahead and search. You say great, activate Dark Knight Lancer, take the Birthomet, and now they don't have that fiend to go ahead and fusion summon into their Chimera plays. Really crazy as well. So there's a lot of bottleneck situations that you can go ahead and use to your advantage, where this card is actually super, super crazy. And that's what I want to go ahead and really emphasize on, because the card is nuts. For the extra deck, guys, two Totally Awesome, one Abyss Dweller, one Stealth Kraken Spawn, two number four Stealth Kraken, two of the Bahama Shark, one Valiant Shark Lancer, one Normal Armor Fortress, one of the Full Armor Crystal Zero, one of the Dark Knight Lancer, one Rare Fish, one Typhon, and one Sky Crisis, and one Double A Zeus. To go ahead and write off the 15 card extra deck. Is really there's a discussion to be made where you probably shouldn't even run Zeus or Sky Crisis, just because they aren't waters, and there's gonna be a lot of times where you want to summon them, but you just been locked out. And that's gonna be it for the deck profile, guys. Now let's go ahead and go over some combos. I'm gonna show you guys is a quick three card combo. This combo is absolutely crazy. The end board is ridiculous. Now I'm gonna show you guys exactly what's gonna give you the best absolute combo and best possible opening for the entire deck. So we're gonna go ahead and start off with the Buzzsaw Shark. Buzzsaw Shark effect's gonna get us our not Nimble Angler, I'm thinking about Sprite. We're gonna get our Silent Angler from our deck to the field. Now it's very important that we have to get Silent Angler, because with White Mirror, it's going to give us an additional extender later on in the combo. So just go ahead and let you guys know you have to search specific things with this type of strategy. We're going to special summon out our Abyss Sharks. Abyss Shark is then going to get us one copy of our XYZ Remora, which this is actually going to be super, super huge, because yes, we are detaching materials special summon, but we actually need to detach materials from one of these cards so we'll be able to use it as an XYZ material itself, which I'll go ahead and show you guys what I mean in just a second. But first things first, guys, we need to make sure that we are playing around Nibiru. So we're going to go ahead and summon out Bahamut Shark as well. Just to go ahead and have the Totally Awesome out in our fifth summon. Now again, you guys have to make sure you detach Silent Angler, or else this is not going to work. You guys are gonna go ahead and special summon out Totally Awesome. Now we're safe, we're clear, no Nibiru's here. We are in the clear, we are golden. We're gonna then go ahead and activate our copy of White Mirror to go ahead and be able to go ahead special summon out our Silent Angler, special summon that, and then White Mirror is gonna give us the amazing advantage that we get to search out another copy of Silent Angler directly to our hands, which is of course a free special summon. Now sequencing is important here, guys, because Silent Angler, when special summoned, you cannot special summon any other monsters from the hand. So if we were to activate this right now, we would not be able to special summon XYZ Remora, and really would not be able to go ahead and get the full benefit of its effect. So we are going to need to go ahead and special summon out our number four Stealth Kraken right here. Now, what we want to do is to go ahead and use the Bahamut Shark and our special summon out our XYZ Armor Fortress. But the issue with this is that this card cannot be used as an XYZ material as long as it has XYZ materials. So we need to make sure this has nothing under it, which we can definitely do because we have the XYZ Remora. So this is what we're going to do. We're going to get a double advantage of this. We're going to go ahead and detach the Buzzsaw Shark from Bahamut Shark, and we're going to get our Silent Angler from our Stealth Kraken. Both level 4s as well, and XYZ Remora has a crazy good effect. On special summon, you can target two level 4 fish monsters in your graveyard and special summon those targets in defense positions. Yeah, their effects are negated, but that is completely irrelevant, believe me. Because we're going to go ahead and go into our copy of Abyss Dweller. There we go. So we're gonna go ahead and get out our Abyss Dweller right here. So we are good to go, but we're not done there, guys. Remember that Silent Angler that we searched out? We're gonna go ahead and special summon this guy for free, and then we're gonna be able to go ahead and summon out our second copy of Bahamut Shark. And you guys already know what that means. Of course, we're already getting out our final copy of Totally Awesome. So let's go ahead and get this guy out over here. So there you have a full XYZ board, but we are still not done. We are still not done. We have then our XYZ Fortress that we have to, of course, make with Bahamut Shark, because now searching By detaching the Bahama Shark, we're going to be able to search the trap card full armored Eggsies, which is going to give us access to the additional Eggsies monster that we have in our extra deck. So it's going to allow us to special summon out this guy, the full armored Dark Knight Lancer, which then is going to allow us to take one of our opponent's monsters, put it under as a material. So here's what we're looking at. Your opponent is having zero graveyard effects with Abyss Dweller, two Omni Negates, all our monsters are water. If we have Gozen Match in our hand, we are instantly, that's an auto win right there. We have heavily boosted monsters. Like I said, two Omni Negates, I mean, this is absolutely crazy. So you have two interruptions, all your opponent's monsters are going to be turned to water. During the main phase, destroy water monsters your opponent controls and inflict damage, which is crazy. So you have destruction, you have non-targeting takes, you have two Omni Negates, no effects in the graveyard, which is like infinite amounts of interruptions, especially if you're playing a deck like Tier Lament, which is definitely going to be one of the best decks of the format. Looking into a more high tier event, I would highly consider this as a potential option in the event that you can fit a lot of going second cards in this. Now this does seem a little bit like very reliant on a potential going first strategy. This is the only thing I do not like about Sharks, but like I said, this is the one of the very best boards they could potentially make, which is absolutely really scary to go up against, of course, but it's something that's at least worth noodling around with, figuring out how we can possibly make this a little bit better. Guys, if you guys have any suggestions on this, let me know in the comment section down below. We'll go ahead and tackle this together. Do you guys think that Sharks are a legitimate rogue tier strategy that can potentially top a regional again as it did 2 months ago? We'll have to go ahead and wait and see, guys. But if you guys have any suggestions, let me know. Comment section down below. Make sure you guys get your merch, like, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one.